1990, Sandy and my wife were second cousins who reconnected when she surprised us one Sunday at a church I was serving in Burr Ridge. As young girls, their families would connect with each other as they visited back and forth from the farm in DeKalb and Chicago. Sandy and Linda quickly renewed their friendship. Not long after, Sandy introduced us to Larry, who she thoroughly enjoyed. He soon popped the marriage question to her. The date was set, and I was asked to marry them in Trinity Lutheran Church, where I was serving. Needless to say, Larry kept us guessing because he arrived fashionably late for the wedding. As I remember, Sandy took several trips to the window while waiting. The day was beautiful, with family and friends gathered around to celebrate with the happy couple. Our friendship through the years continued with trips to Springfield and their trips to our home in Munster, Indiana. We still haven't met anyone who would drive 200 miles to get their hair cut by their favorite person. Dinner conversations like no other we would have. The doctor came out in Larry many times as he shared with us the latest findings on this and that. On more than one occasion, his advice was greatly appreciated. His incredible collection of antique medical instruments could be displayed in any medical museum. The stories he told connected with some of these instruments were fascinating and amusing. A shared interest in history and Lincoln always led to much discussion. We were invited to spend time with those snowbirds in Arizona. Being from the Midwest, we look forward to these beautiful trips filled with good times, including relaxing conversations, great food and wine. Larry knew his way around an outdoor grill. Sandy would make delicious side dishes and always serve dinner with a flair. We enjoyed the beautiful Southwest scenery, warm weather, and excellent conversation. In so many ways, they were made for each other. All in good fun, when they would go back and forth in their discussions, I would playfully call them the Bickersons. I still hear Larry responding to Sandy, "It's all Larry's fault." Oh, how they loved and enjoyed each other. We will miss him. No, he rests in heavenly peace with his Lord. God's peace and comfort be with you, Sandy, and the family. And now we turn to God's word to be strengthened and refreshed as we continue. From Psalm 130, out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. O Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to the voice of my pleas for mercy. If you, O Lord, should mark iniquities, O Lord, who could stand? But with you there is forgiveness, that you may be feared. I wait for the Lord, my soul waits, and in his word I hope. My soul waits for the Lord more than watchmen for the morning. More than watchmen for the morning. O Israel, hope in the Lord, for with the Lord there is steadfast love, and with him is plentiful redemption. And he will redeem Israel from all his iniquities. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From Isaiah chapter 40. Lift up your eyes on high and see who created these. He who brings out their host by number, calling them all by name. By the greatness of his might and ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases strength. Even youths shall faint and be weary, and young men shall fall exhausted. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with eagles, with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And finally, from Philippians chapter 3. But our citizenship is in heaven, and from it we await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our lowly bodies to be like his glorious body by the power that enables him even to subject all things to himself. Therefore, my brothers, whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm thus in the Lord, my beloved. This is the word of the Lord.